looks like a storeroom. We must be getting close to their hideout.
There they are. And now we've got them.
It's the guy we tied up. Where's Diamond?
Over here, it's our only chance.
Don't shoot. He'll blow up all our ammunition.
Yeah, what of it?
Peggy's father.
Drummond's still alive and they're headed this way.
They're going to take him away in the plane.
Maybe we can stop them.
There they are now.
Jerry, jump!
Let's take no chances. You know what the dragon will do to us if we lose Planet?
You're right. Get in there.
Come on, hurry up.
Hey, are you working for the dragon too? What's the idea of making me jump? That's two I owe you.
Got a scheme.
You stick your nose out of here, you'll get it shot off.
No, no. Not me. You watch, Tommy. I'm going to outflank these guys.
Contact Vitel Field and tell them we're on our way.
Right.
Monastery and find out. Take me with you, will you, Peggy?
All right.
bình ngon.
Mũ con, tấn ở tình can.
Cháu dành lì ạ.
Dành dành hút bình ngon.
It'll be dark before we reach the monastery. There's a car behind us. I wonder if it's following us. Step on it and see.
I warn you that the dragon is about to strike. You must turn back at once.
You seem well informed of the dragon's plan.
I tell you, you're risking your lives.
Thanks for the warning, Mr. Key. We wish to see the Lama. Lama.
A thousand pardons if I intrude. But did you wish to see the Grand Lama?
Yes.
I'm Chang Ho, humble disciple of the Holy One.
Please take me to him. I must see him at once.
It is forbidden for a woman to enter the monastery, but you may wait in the courtyard.
Thank you.
You may wait here.
The last time I was here was the day Ace's plane went out of control. We crashed against that wall.
Oh, you sure were lucky to get out of that alive.
What is it, my son?
Great lady from the airport wishes to speak to the Holy One.
I will see her.
Here comes the Grand Lama.
Chang Ho tells me you are looking for Mr. Drummond. He left some hours ago.
Could you tell me which way he went?
I'm sorry, I cannot tell you that. He and his friend flew away without leaving any word.
Thank you. Well, Billy, I guess there's nothing we can do except go back to the airport.
If Ace and Jerry had been gone that long, without getting back to the airport, there's only one answer. They crashed.
Well, can't we do something?
Say, Peggy, that day you crashed, did Ace take that signal pistol out of the plane?
I don't think so, Billy. Why? Excuse me, please.
If he's within 10 miles of here, he'll see this.
Howie. We're in Mongolia, and this ain't the 4th of July.
There's no doubt about it, Jerry. That's a distress signal.
You don't suppose something's happened to the Queen of the Orient, do you?
No, she couldn't have gotten here so soon. That's coming from the monastery. Come on.
Signal.
Yes, what's up?
Ace, you've got to get to the airport right away. The Queen of the Orient...
I know, Peggy, I know. Come on, let's get to your car.
Will be within striking distance in 20 minutes. Every man to his post.
Are you sure the ray is working?
Aye. What about Ace Drummond? Suppose he warns the Queen of the Orient.
Don't worry, the dragon is taking care of that.
I hope we get to the airport in time to warn the Clipper.
Look out, Ace.
Ace Drummond calling Queen of the Orient. Ace Drummond calling Queen of the Orient. Answer, Queen of the Orient.
What are you going to do, Drummond?
We've got to stop that ship. We heard the dragon give orders to bring her down.
But isn't it dangerous to try to contact her?
We've got to take that chance. Ace Drummond calling Queen of the Orient.
When the pilot answers, let him have it.
Queen of the Orient, go ahead, Drummond.
Turn back. Turn back.
It's Drummond. He says turn back.
The dragon commands.